Lotus Resources is Keith Bowes. Keith, good morning.
Hi, Andrew. How are you?
Very good, Keith. News towards the end of last week here, the acquisition of the Livingstonia uranium project in Malawi. Tell us a bit more about it.
Now, we're really excited about this. It's when we were doing some of our review of the regional tenements that we had, because I think, as we've mentioned previously on these talks, when we did acquire the asset from Kayelekera, from Paladin, we did actually get a number of exploration licenses as well. And we spent the last few months having a look through those exploration licenses, trying to understand what's there. And we recognize this potential that sits just outside one of our existing tenements. And therefore, we've gone and pursued that. And as you've said, we've had a really, really big success there, I think, in terms of acquiring that and repegging it as well. So we're really happy with it.
You mentioned the purchase price, 25 grand. Seems fairly reasonably priced for the acquisition. What are we missing?
Yeah, so in terms of it being an acquisition price, the way that the deal worked is there was a local Malawian who owned the tenement, or one of the tenements that we acquired. He hadn't done anything on it for many, many years. So what we did is we struck a deal with them where effectively we paid him the $25,000 in turn for him effectively dropping the license and allowing us to re-peg it. So that was effectively what the deal was about. Rather than us buying anything directly off with them, we just facilitated a transaction with them whereby we were able to peg the ground that he owned, as well as pegging more ground as well. We actually extended the other tenement further than what he originally owned.
So how will this impact or change your work programs for the year ahead?
In terms of the core work that we've always spoken about getting the feasibility study done by the middle of next year and then focusing on the restart of the asset, it really doesn't make a lot of difference in terms of what we're doing. However, what we do recognize, it does give us some upside moving forward. We are planning on doing some exploration work there later this year. So we've already had our guys go down onto the site. They've had a look around to see what the conditions are like for access and those types of things. And according to our plan at the moment, we'll probably send our drill rigs, which have just completed our work up at Kayelekera, down there to do some drilling just to give us an idea of potentially what the extensions are. And we may also do some drilling over the existing Livingstonia resource with the concept of actually converting that into a JORC 2012 compliant resource as well. But in terms of the core work, no, it's not going to make any difference. It's not going to slow us down or anything like that. We just see it as an upside that we would be able to add to any production plans going forward.
You mentioned the DFS there for Kayelekera. How's that tracking?
That's going well. So we've mentioned, as I said, delivery or completing the study by the middle of next year. That's still on target. Most of our consultants that we want to work on it have already been appointed and are already well into the program. So we're going out, full steam ahead on that at the moment. We don't see any issues with the delivery date from middle of next year.
How's the exploration program around the mine? Any updates there?
Yeah, so we've finished all of the uranium exploration work there. So that was the work that we spoke about on those little satellite deposits down to the south, but more focused around extending the resource around the existing Kayelekera resource, which is being, where our main work. All of that work's been done now. The samples have been selected and have been sent down to the laboratories in South Africa for assaying. The drill rig moved about 2 weeks ago up to Malenji, which is where the rare earth anomaly is. So the drill rig's busy up there at the moment, should be finished in the next week or two at Malenji. And then the idea is if we can get it arranged in time is for that drill rig to then move down to Livingstonia and do some drilling down in Livingstonia for us.
Since you and I last spoke, Keith, I think a month or two back, how's the uranium price been performing?
Yes, I think probably when we last spoke, it was sort of at its peak, the $51 that it achieved about 3 weeks ago, I think. It took a little bit of a drop after that. But it's back up to $47 per pound today. So we're still happy with that. But the thing that we're really interested in that we're trying to get our get some information on is where do we think the term price sits at the moment? The spot price is great, but let's try and understand where the term price is, because obviously as a future developer, we're interested in signing term contracts. And that's what our focus is trying to get an idea of where the term price is sitting at the moment.
Good to see you, Keith. Thanks very much.
Thanks very much, Andrew.